Jay Shrek.
James.
Falling a damn. No, don't you dare stop that. James fell in a hole. He wanted to shut it off because he's going to go, people don't know I stumble and fall. You fell yesterday and so did I, right?
Start.
Yeah.
Where are we today?
Jay Shrek, Miss Legends and Lies with
James.
We are at the Pueblo La Plata. Now, what's cool about today was, is it's just kind of a freestyle. I've never been up here. We're on the Perry Mesa, and it was like, hey, let's just follow some signs. And, man, it's gravel. Look at the gravel. I mean, I'm pretty impressed. It's a big deal to me. James doesn't find it so cool as I do, but I'm like, there's like gravel, and I know what kind of work it took. I used to drive a truck one time, a gravel truck, right? So the amount of effort and the amount of work it took to get out here and get this gravel out here, I appreciate, you know. So we're going to go to this Pueblo on Perry Mesa, and not Perry Mason, but it's still a mystery. That's good if you really caught that. And we're going to see what's down here. We don't really have any idea. This is going to be just a journey of journeys. And the good news is, as James said, is that looks like an easy hike, not like what we did yesterday. We may have caused our grief yesterday by doing what we did, but
looks like we get it easy.
It is what it is. So let's take it easy. Let's go through the gates.
Here we go. We'll do a little walkthrough.
Now, we're supposed to see two different things down here, so that should be interesting. Now, the trail looks like it. Oh, there's plenty of holes that we want to make sure you don't fall in. Tell you the only thing you got to be careful of, it looks like if these are gopher holes, there's thousands of them. And I can't wait to see the little head stick out, if that's what it is. But that's what I'm guessing it is. Well, we're almost halfway to the first location.
We're getting there.
Man, well, it looks like we got a big, we can really tell we're going to be on a mesa over here is what it looks like. Okay, real quick. You know, as you're checking your stuff, when you do this as much as we've done it, and you look, now there's the truck. And there's where we're going. And I'm about halfway is what I'm looking at. But you know, one thing that I forgot to do was bring water. Now, that's like ridiculous. But that happens. So what do? I'm going to tell you what you do. You go back and get some water. And you take the hike and you take the walk. Because last thing you want to do is, even though we're not in any danger, and could I not? Yeah, there's no doubt. I could, you know, I can make it. But that's dumb not to. I'd rather go hike back, grab a couple bottles of water, have it just in case. You never know what could possibly happen, and it's dumb not to. But that's some of the mistakes, even though we do this a lot. It's one of my dumbass mistakes. Shards. Now, I call them shards. You call them sherds. What is it, James?
I have no idea how to pronounce it. I just go off the fact that it's S-H-E-R-D-S on all the actual archaeological sites.
Because I've always called them shards, but maybe it's the shard police versus the shard police.
Maybe.
Still the police, right?
Now, if you look, they're going to tell you how to do it.
Now, if you look through here, they're everywhere. There's 50, 60, 80 pieces of pottery in this area right here, and we haven't even got into the facility. But that's what you expect to see. You know, the garbage, as you would say, is going to be twice or three times as much depending on how many people live there. Now, one thing that you brought up that's really interesting to me was, now if you look up that valley right there and you look up this mesa, I should say, there were Indian settlements, encampments all the way up to Flagstaff. So when people think there's only one or two of these things, they were everywhere. What was the rule? Like 15 minutes, James? What is something
along
like that?
Along that line, where there was so many communities established along this corridor that they had a communications set up. So basically, like, you could run from place to place to make any, you know, to talk about whatever's going on, if you're getting raided or if you're running out of water.
Or whatever the Kardashians might be doing, TMZ.
Yeah, exactly.
The original version of TMZ, basically.
Essentially, this is ancient.
Ancient TMZ.
Ancient gossip.
And that really is true, really.
I would imagine.
Now, this thing was multi-level.
Yes.
And it also had a wall around it. And it would have been pretty intimidating if you would have come up over that mesa and you would have saw it. Now, what I'd like to do is I would like to see what kind of remnants are just laying around as we step up into the facility and see what's really up there to kind of get an idea. Now, one thing about up here too is the wind up here on these mesas is unbelievable. So you would have got these walls not being able to continue to stand with the amount of beating they would have taken, like out in the open. You know, if you come up here and you take a look at this area right here, other than I've fallen down, what you're going to find is they seem like sites we've seen that have been robbed. Now, I don't know if you call them grave robbers, but people that come in to steal this stuff. The way they're dug deep, kind of like they were looking for stuff, and they had a system in place. And you can see, kind of see how they've destroyed most of these places. But you know, this is early 1900s. This isn't 1982. You know, I won't say that it didn't happen later, but these sites were ravaged and pillaged, I guess you could say, by people's grandfathers and great-grandfathers. That's where all this really happened. But you know, another thing that drove that was people willing to pay prices for Indian pottery and things like that. So because there was a market for it, these people would come out here and they would tear this stuff up. And today, I don't believe there's nearly the kind of stuff going on as used to be. Not that it doesn't happen, because that would be foolish to say, but that's what a lot of this is that people came in, especially this hole here. This definitely looks like somebody came in and dug down to try to find pottery and things like that and artifacts to sell.
That adds to the breaking down of the wall structures over time.
And you know, because of this stuff, and I don't think these people felt it was wrong. I really don't. They didn't realize the value in it. And that's the people that came before us. So at least thank goodness that Bill Clinton had the foresight when they bought this land to be able to save this structure, at least to be able to hold on to it and to take care of it. This would have been a massive structure to look at. It would have been 3 stories tall. I mean, it would have been really something unbelievable to see sitting up on this mesa if you would have saw this and rode a horse in or walked in, you know, 600, 700, 800 years ago. You know, there's still some walls that look really good. That's a good one right here. That's a good structure right there. It's still intact. And if you look around here, you know, there's pottery pieces everywhere. I mean, you know, regardless of where you walk. And this would have been something to see back in the day. You know, a lot of these got torn up in the early 1900s by the early cowboys, because they were the only people that came out here. So that's why we know that's who it was. The early cowboys came out here. Look at that wall there, James. That's probably one of my favorite right there.
It's very much intact, huh?
Nice. You know, and with the exception of some of the huts that they put together, most everything was squared off, just like the construction of today, which I find really be fascinating. Because, you know, they had guys that were considered to be more of the architects, just as well as we have architects today. You know, everybody had a specialty, whether it be pottery making, weaving, architect building, you know, farming. Everybody had a purpose on these mesas. Okay, so the fort. So now we're going to go to the fort, which is Fort Silver, which from the map said just continue to walk through, right? So the trail down here should walk us wherever Fort Silver was.
Yeah, so we'll just follow the trail.
It looks like there's a structure way over there.
We'll keep on moving, see what we find.
So let's take a look and see.
You know, the National Park System, garbage as old as this is actually considered part of the park, and it is illegal to clean it up. I mean, found that quite interesting. I was reading about that the other day.
Well, you know, this tells you something to me. It was old cowboys. It was old grave robbers. I mean, this is old-time stuff right here.
Yeah, that's old remnants. Looks like someone's kind of gathered them all.
You know, James was just talking about, well, why don't you explain, James, about the five-eyed babies? What the hell?
Well, I was just thinking, like, we think of it in such a rudimentary way, but the idea of these communities all existing within distance of each other, and you have 3,000 people in this mesa area, you know, families are going to have to find other people to marry into so that you don't have
five-eyed babies
and other, yeah, you know, genetic mutations from incest. So it's just something to keep in mind, because we kind of oversimplify, I think, in our brains sometimes about these, like, ancient, quote-unquote, ancient communities.
Yeah, because that's the thing, is for some reason you don't want to put them in a human category at some times. I don't.
Well, you just maybe put it in so far, yeah, in the past, yeah, you think that it's like Stone Age, and the idea is these had, you know, their brains work the same, and so their communities and social structures were just as complex as ours are today.
This is something I did not expect to see. I did not expect to see
Yeah, you know, I'm nature boy, so this canyon alone has kind of got me very excited because that's just such a gorgeous outlook. I would have lived up here too.
Now, one thing, a lot of people don't walk to the end of the mesa, but me and James were committed to go all the way to the end because Fort Silver was supposed to be down here. And on the very end of the mesa, look what we found. The foundation for Fort Silver. This place is really, really neat. But don't miss taking the hike all the way down to the end of the mesa because this is definitely something that's really pretty cool. Agree with me, James?
Yeah, definitely glad we kept walking.
Because, with forts, you don't know. We discussed, and there's nothing left. But look at this. How incredible is this? I like the different structures that are still here. Now, I don't know who built this, and I'm not sure if this was... Now, this is Fort Silver, but we're not sure about the rest of that, and we'll have to do a little research and find out. Now, was this maybe an ancient ruin that then the army might have taken over and built their fort in, or was this just an ancient ruin? Because the architecture is exactly the same as the Indian walls we've seen. It's identical. And I tell you what, this neat outcropping out here is really pretty spectacular. I mean, you look at that wall back there, I'd love to get down in that canyon and take a look up. It would have been a beehive of activity. So they would have been all over here hunting and working and gathering and farming. And this would have been a very active community up here. So there should be a lot of remnants. Sounds like a rock wall right there too. You think about this as being a fort and you look down into the canyon, you know, you can tell that it'd been very difficult to attack this position. It'd been extremely difficult. You know, every day we come out here, I'm laughing because it's like, I think I've seen the best, right? And every day we come out, and especially like today, you know, this was just on a whim, and then we found the fort. And we found this point down here, and it's gorgeous. This is beautiful.
Yeah, you really can't beat a view like this. You know, a couple ruins like this. So this is a really cool spot, man. This canyon is just unbelievable.
And then to be out on this point.
This is the other side of the canyon where we were looking at.
Now there is mining down there, right? That's mining.
That absolutely, he's talking about these tailings that we see over here.
That's a mine.
He's really curious. We found this little bit off this rock that appears someone's either chipped or maybe some natural erosion of some sort, but there appears to be some form of tailings and chippings off of that rock. So that's why we're sitting right here kind of
debating.
Trying to figure it out.
Because now over on that mount, that's definitely
mining.
That's right mining there. Right there. There's an old mine up there. So there could be something. That makes me think maybe this isn't crazy.
Yeah, no, someone could have been speculating down there.
Yeah. That's nutty. That is nutty. But you never know. Man, what a beautiful area.
Prospecting, I think, is what the word would be I'm looking for. But yeah, I mean, you can't beat views like this 2 days in a row, man.
Yeah, absolutely. Awesome. How beautiful
is
this?
Agua Fria is great.
Agua Fria is awesome.
You can do this.
And the road was good. Road was really good.
What did you find?
Looks like a grinding hole.
Some form?
Yeah.
Water grinding hole of some sort?
Yeah. I mean,
yeah, that looks real deep for just rain to have caused.
Yeah, I don't see anything.
Let me get you guys a better view.
That definitely looks like something that's been worked. This funny about this plateau, these rocks, usually when they're this big, they're stable.
Yeah, they keep moving under our feet.
Yeah, and these moving.
Anxious.
They give you a little gut check there.
Well, this is a little walk back. I'm talking loud in case you can't hear the mic. From the fort, and if you were to look directly ahead of us, is the other site that we came from. So this is a large, large area on top of this mesa that you can explore.
Okay, that looks like something right there. Okay, there's the first one that actually, that looks like something. Right there.
Oh, there you go. I think he finally found some remnants of carving.
Now that's carved.
Too, yeah. That's actual carved, I believe.
That's definitely carved right there. Now that could be an S, could be, let's say it is a military base, could be an S for an initial, or could definitely in this area be a snake. That was gonna be all over, so that definitely could be a carving of a snake. I was just gonna see if maybe just right in here, you know, there maybe was some, because they would be on these ridges, I would think. You know, if you are out here and it's getting really hot and there's no breeze, there is a magical thing that you can do, is we've got a magic word. If you say the magic word, it will almost guarantee that the wind will start blowing. What's that word?
Drone.
Drone. If you say drone, we'd like to get the drone out, we'd like to fly the drone, automatically wind will start blowing. It already just did, didn't it? It's incredible. That's nice. But you know, I would have thought we'd have found a lot more of those, James, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I would have expected to see a lot more petroglyphs by now, but
you know, there's one that
really
says,
it shows to keep your eye out.
Well, I read those and that says that this is the only one. So
these termites eat.
Eat them termites. Eat them termites. I know you like termites.
Ooh, fast. I've never seen them babies like that.
Jay Shrek!
And James.
Where in the hell are we at today, James?
Pueblo La Plata.
And La Plata means?
Silver.
Yes, because that's Silver Creek down below, and we're on a big mesa, really. That's exactly what we're on right now, right?
Yes, we are.
So we're really on the north, south, and west is sheer cliffs. So this was a very defendable position. Now, they're saying that this structure was a couple stories, housed somewhere around 250 people, and the people left here sometime around 1450, which I find incredible only because the Casa Grande ruins was also 1450. He fell in the hole. James fell in the hole again.
Twice.
So, and that happened to the ancients a lot too. They fell in holes also, which is terrible, but they did.